Now, that in itself is a very small piece of this puzzle that I have been through. People have said, gee, I wish I had that experience. Well, I'll tell you, I'd trade places with you any time. Because since that day, my life is gone. Everything that I knew prior to that is gone. My job, my friends, my bank accounts, my social security number, everything. And why? Because I saw something? Because I didn't turn it over to somebody who told me to turn it over? Because people came to my house and said, you didn't see anything, Jonathan. And if you have anything, you best give it to us, because the next people that come won't be so kind. And I told them to get out of my house. And I said, I'm going to call the police. They said, go ahead. They're with us. And they were. They were sitting out in front of my house. Now, this is a hard lesson to take. I was brought up to believe different things happen in this country. But my rights have been totally taken away from me. And all I ask is that people open their minds and understand that this stuff may be going on to some of us. Maybe not you, maybe not your neighbor, but I know it's going on to hundreds of people in this country and other countries. I know there is a very dark force that is suppressing this information. I know that there is a lot of information that a few of us, not me, I know very little, but there are a few people who know a great deal, and we need to listen to them. And we need to realize that not everything that we've always been told is true. And that not everyone who stands in this room stands for the truth and the freedom of information. And there are a couple of people in this room that I know that work for the government, that posture as normal people, that stand there and try to emulate one of the rest of us. And those people know who they are, don't they? But we need to realize this. We need to know that those people are with us. Where am I? After I brought this thing home, I went in my house and I tried to regain some composure. And I tried to think this through. I tried to find some kind of rational logic to deal with what I was experiencing. Had I gone through shock? Had my dog been killed by something that I just did not want to wrap my mind around? Possibly. And after a while, that's what I started to believe. I started to believe that maybe my mind had totally invented this whole thing, and that wrapped in my thermal blanket was my dog. And I got to the point where I had to check. I had to go back and look. So I went out of my house and I walked to where I had put this thing, which was in my freezer in my garage. And as odd as that may sound, where would you put this thing? And I opened my freezer and I laid this out on the floor, and it wasn't my dog. And I brought this thing in my house and laid it on the floor and videotaped it. And we have that videotape, and we can show that now.